Now that we know what indefinite integrals are, let's talk about the net change theorem. So we start with the fundamental theorem of calculus, which I'll remind you says that if you've got a function little f and a function big F that's an antiderivative of little f, then the integral of little f from a to b is big F of b minus big F of a. This is by far and away the most useful aspect of the fundamental theorem of calculus, and this is how we go about computing integrals. We find antiderivatives, and we plug them in at the endpoints, and we use this notation, big F of x with a bar to the right. Whenever you put a bar in two numbers, means plug in this value and subtract off what you get when you plug in this value. But what if we had the integral of f prime from a to b? How can we figure out the integral of f prime? Well, we have to find an antiderivative to f prime. Fortunately, we know a function whose derivative is f prime. That's just f. And we plug that in, and we get f of b minus f of a. This is the net change theorem. In some ways, it's a trivial consequence of the fundamental theorem of calculus, but it has a significant meaning for the real world. It tells us that if you want to figure out the net change in any function f of x, what you do is you have to figure out the derivative of the function and then integrate the derivative. The integral of the derivative is the net change. So for example, if our function is supposed to represent velocity, you want to know the net change of the velocity, the final velocity minus the initial velocity. Well, that's the integral of the derivative of velocity, otherwise known as acceleration. If you know the acceleration, integrate it, and you get the change in the velocity. If you want the final position minus the initial position, the net displacement of a particle in its trajectory, you have to integrate the derivative of position, which of course is the velocity. So these net changes are all given by the integrals of derivatives. So let's do a physics problem to illustrate these ideas. So we're on the ground, we grab a ball, and we throw it in the air, we throw it upwards with an initial speed of 96 feet per second. That tick mark just means feet. Of course, gravity is acting on it, and so it's accelerating downwards at negative 32 feet per second squared. So we want to know what is the net change in velocity in the first 6 seconds of its flight. And then what's the net change in the position in the first 6 seconds of its flight. And finally, how far does our ball travel between the time we launch it and 6 seconds later? So to get the change in velocity, we have to integrate the acceleration. The acceleration is negative 32 feet per second squared. We integrate that, and to do that, we need to find a function whose derivative is negative 32. That's pretty easy. That's negative 32 t, evaluated at 0 and at 6. This is minus 192 minus 0. So that's minus 192. And the units are feet per second. So the final velocity is 192 feet per second less than the initial velocity. Remember, the initial velocity was 96 feet per second. The final velocity is 192 feet per second less than that. So that means that our final velocity is negative 96 feet per second. And going from 96 to negative 96, the change is negative 192. Okay, now we want to understand what is our change in position. But to do that, we first need to figure out what our velocity is. To find the change in velocity, we had to do a definite integral. To find the velocity itself, we have to find an antiderivative or an indefinite integral. So if we want to know the velocity at time t, that's a function whose derivative is negative 32, so it's negative 32 t plus a constant. We figure out that constant by plugging in the value at time 0, At time 0, the velocity was 96, and that's negative 32 times 0 plus c, which is c. So c is 96. Our velocity at time t is 96 minus 32t. Once we have our velocity, we can figure out the change in our position. The change in our position, I'm going to call the position z because it's height, is the integral of our velocity. That's the integral of 96 minus 32t dt. And for that, we need to find a function whose derivative is 96 minus 32t. Well, 96t is a function whose derivative is 96. And 16t squared is a function whose derivative is 32t. We evaluate it at 0 and then at 6. 96 times 6 minus 16 times 6 squared is 576 minus 576, which is 0. The net change in our position is 0. In fact, we launched the ball into the air, and 6 seconds later, it hits the ground. It came right back to where it started from. Its final position minus its initial position is 0. This illustrates the difference between net change versus total change. If you want to know how much the position has changed, or what's the distance traveled, you probably want to count the distance it went going up, and then you want to count the distance going down. You don't want to take the difference. So the net change theorem says the net change is the integral of the derivative. The total distance traveled is a little trickier. If you want the total distance traveled, you don't want to integrate the velocity, you want to integrate the speed. No matter what direction you're going, you rack up your miles at the rate of whatever speed you're going times time. So you integrate the speed, which is the absolute value of velocity, to get the distance traveled. In this case, that's the absolute value of 96 minus 32t. So how do we get an absolute value? Well, an absolute value is the function itself as long as it's positive, and it's minus the function as long as it's negative. And this is positive for the first 3 seconds, and then it becomes negative. So this becomes, for the first 3 seconds, we get the integral of 96 minus 32t. And for the last 3 seconds, we get the integral of 32t minus 96. And you evaluate that, and you get this integral is 96t minus 16t squared, evaluated at 0 and at 3. This is 16t squared minus 96t. Evaluated at 3 and at 6, and you do a little bit of arithmetic, and you discover that the answer is 288 feet. The ball went up to 144 feet, it went down 144 feet, the total distance traveled is 288 feet, but the net distance is 0.